you shall bless the children of Israel. Say unto them, the Lord bless you and the Lord keep you. The Lord make his face upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. And they shall put my name upon the children of Israel, and I will bless them. So every time you are impacted, your level changes. Your life changes. The way you look at things changes. Impartation is for transformation. Someone, you came here at one level today, you are going to another level. You won't go back the same way you came. You won't go back with the same level with which you came. But because every impartation leads to a transformation. I don't know how you came here, but one thing is sure, you won't go back the same way you came. Every encounter that is genuine, that leads to an impartation, automatically brings about the transformation. Every encounter that is genuine, actually took place, you will find out that there's a transformation that takes place. If you meet someone that is HIV positive, now there will be an impartation of the HIV virus. So you are transformed from wellness to sickness. That's a negative transformation. That's why people disinfect. That's why people, you know, clean their systems, their hands, so that they don't be negatively impacted. That's why Dettol is selling. And that's why hand sanitizers sold a great deal. Because people do not want to be impacted negatively. Every encounter, if the meeting actually takes place, there will be something impacted. Except you didn't have that encounter. Except you danced around it, or meandered around it. But if there was encounter and God meets you, or you meet with that thing, you will exchange some things. There will be an impartation. You never remain the same again. Somebody slept with a girl and said, I only slept with that woman and she said she's pregnant. I said, it's enough. It's enough. It is enough. It's enough. If it actually took place, it's enough. Anything could happen. Because there was an exchange of what he had and what you have. So there's possibility that you will be transformed from being single to being disbanded to becoming pregnant. So three levels of transformation instantly. Because of that encounter that you have. When it comes to God, God transforms us for the better, not for evil. Say, I know the thoughts that I think towards you. They are thoughts of good and not of evil. Anytime God meets with you, he wants you to become better than how you were before. It is for good. It is always for good. I know the thoughts that I think towards you. Thoughts of good. Jeremiah 29 verse 11. I want it to be better for you. Say, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and power, who is about doing good. His impartation is for good. So that your life will become better. Transformation to a better life. Some people are transformed from grace to grass. But God wants to move you from grass to grace. It's always for the better. God wants it to be better. God wants it to be better. All the time. In Psalm 84 verse 11 it said, the Lord will give grace and glory. The Lord will give grace and glory. No good thing will he withhold from them that walk upright. So anytime you come to me, I want to give you good. The Lord will give grace and glory. Anytime you come to me, I want to unleash on you something gracious and something glorious. For the Lord will give grace and glory. He said, no good thing will he withhold from them that walk uprightly. So it means your time for answer prayer has just started. No good thing will he withhold from them that walk upright. So he will give you this answer. Yes. No good thing. You will look at you and say, no, you can't get this one. You say, take this one. Which one again? Take this one. No good thing will he withhold we look at, is this good? Do you like it? Is it good for you? Say, take. Say, like it, that one too is good. Say, okay, that's good. Take. If you look and say, that one from is good. You say, throw me for no good thing will he withhold from them that walk uprightly. This year, therefore, you will be having good things in multiple. Good house, good car, good wife, good husband, good job, good look, good appearance, good car, good shoe, good suit, everything good. No good thing will he withhold. He said, how? If you are evil, know how to give good gifts. Luke 11, 13. How much more shall your heavenly Father give the Holy Ghost to them that ask him? Matthew 7, 7, Matthew 7, 8, Matthew 7, 9. He said, if you who are evil know how to give good gifts, how much more shall your heavenly Father give good things to them that ask him? How much more shall your heavenly Father give good things to them that ask him? He said, ask and you shall receive, seek and you shall find, knock and door shall be opened unto you. He said, if you are evil know how to give good gifts, how much more shall your heavenly Father give good things to them that ask him? The Lord will give grace and glory. In this year of multiple grace, that means multiple good will be coming to you. You will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. I said you will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. You will eat the good of the land. Say, if you be willing and obedient, ye shall eat the good of the land. So it's an impartation for good. Something good. Everything that has not been good around you, I see God turning them to good. Everything that has not been good around you, I see God turning them to good for you. In the mighty name of Jesus. If you have been looking at any area of your life and saying, I don't like this, it is not good enough. This time around, there will be a transformation. There will be goodness imparted to you. There will be goodness imparted to you. Somebody say, I receive the goodness of the Lord. I receive grace. I receive glory. No good thing shall be withheld from me. My impartation is for transformation to something good, something better, something best, something glorious. And from glory to glory. I can hear your voice. If your worship is not good, God will turn it to good. All you need to do is have an encounter with God, receive an impartation over that affair, and then up it goes into the realm of goodness. It is impartation for transformation. The mystery of multiplication is impartation. The mystery of multiplication is impartation. Impartation is the mystery behind every multiplication. Nothing multiplies until there is an impartation. John 12, 24 says, when a grain of seed is on the ground alone, it remains alone like that. But if it is imparted to the ground, and the seed and the ground meet together, and the seed enters into the ground, then it will no longer be alone. Verily, verily, I say unto you, except a corn of wheat fall into the ground and die, it abideth alone. But if it die, it bringeth forth much fruit. The mystery behind multiplication is impartation. Impart it to the ground. Just release, let the ground and the seed have an intercourse. And then you will see what will begin to happen with multiplication. But if you withhold and you don't release, then there will be no multiplication. The mystery of multiplication is impartation. If your life is going to ever be better than how it is now, you must constantly be imparted, or you remain the way you are. It is impartation that leads to any promotion in life. It is impartation that leads to any transformation to a higher height in life. It is impartation that leads to any promotion, any lifting, any transformation. If you want to become a lecturer in university, then you must constantly be imparted with knowledge to a master's level, to a PhD level, and to a professor level. But you don't get imparted with more knowledge, with more information, you cannot attain. True or false? You want promotion in your place of work, then you must go and acquire some more skills, then you do some short-term courses, you do some professional training, then you get certificated, you get chartered, you get, you know, approved, or you get called to bar, or you get inducted. Then when you are inducted, then you are now moved, because you have been impacted with new level of information and skill. Then you are transformed from ordinary doctor, now they call you registrar, what do they call them? And then you go become senior registrar. You know I'm a school, we are used to register of marking attendants. You become a senior registrar. Very soon, you start doing some residency program, then they say, it's not a consultant. You must constantly be impacted if there's going to be a transformation. You can't speak Kunduku and become transformed. You will remain Kunduku as me. Kunduku means no addition. Kunduku is a new bad word that can be anglicized to Kunduku as me. The more the addition, the more the impartation, the more the transformation. The more the impartation, the more the transformation. If you ever want to grow, you eat in the morning, eat in the afternoon, eat in the evening, every day. If you are not a member of this chapel, at least every day for 1 week. If you are a member of this chapel, at least 1 day you should not eat a week, so that your life can grow and then evangelism can take place and your life can become better. Praise God. But if you eat 3 times a day, 7 days a week, and regularly and sufficiently, I tell you, your body will increase. Even if inside your genes they don't grow, you will start growing. If your flesh does not grow, something will grow somewhere. Who is following what I'm saying? Because you are getting impacted with food. So what you are impacted with affects your nature of transformation. If you are impacted with junk, you listen to dead music, satanic music, Doro Buchi music, then you become Doro anyway. Then you become a Doro yourself. Whatever Doro stands for, you start Doroing your life anyway. Whatever you get impacted with is what you will become. We become what we see. We become what we eat. We become what we associate with. Proverbs 13:20, for example, said, "He that wants to be wise man shall be wise. A companion of fools shall be destroyed." And so your association determines your destination. And it determines your final destiny. He said, evil communication corrupts good manners. Evil communication corrupts good manners. So it means good communication corrects bad manners. If you have bad manners and moving with good people, you get corrected. But if you keep moving with bad people, your evil communication will corrupt your good manners. If you have good manners before, it becomes bad manners when you meet with evil people. But if you have bad manners before and you meet with good people, you get corrected. Because you see the way they are behaving, they are orderly here, they are sensible here, they talk reasonably here. You like to correct your own excesses because you have met with good people. Somebody say impartation for transformation. Impartation is the mystery for every multiplication. If my life will multiply, I must have impartation. So if anything will increase in your life, you must be constantly imparted. Nothing multiplies until there's an impartation. There was this woman, you know her very well, she's in 1 Kings chapter 17, verse number 10 down to 14. She met a prophet. She had her last cup to eat and die. But the prophet said, if you can do some impartation with your seed into my life, make for me a cake first. That's it. Impart me with what you have. Give me what you have. I'll give you what I have. You have physical, carnal substance. I have spiritual substance. Let us mix the two together in a process of impartation. And let us see the outcome. So he said, go and make me a cake first. And as soon as she went trying to do that,
He said, the barrel of men shall not waste. The cruise of oil shall not run dry. And that was exactly what happened. If she never makes the cake first, the world will find nothing to multiply.
Do you understand what we are talking about here?
So, every impartation leads to a multiplication.
Every impartation leads to a multiplication.
He said, 5,000 people will be fed here. But can we get 5 loaves and 2 fishes? And then we bless it. Without the 5 loaves and 2 fishes, the 5,000 will be hungry. There's a need for an impartation on both sides. You release, he releases. So you mix up together and there's multiplication. Impartation is for multiplication. One cannot multiply. 1 times 1 times 1 times 1 times 1 1 times 1